Salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man walaha ma ba'd. Continuing on the message of the metaphors of the Quran when it comes to iman, one of the most beautiful and profound symbols or symbolic verses in the Quran, one of the most beautiful parables that Allah has given, is the verse which is called Ayat An-Nur, which is verse number 35 of Surah An-Nur. And the commentary of this verse is way beyond what we can give justice to in 10-15 minutes. Suffice to point out that out of the 6,000 verses of the Quran, this one, 6,000 plus, this one verse has been commented on more than all of the other verses. This one verse, Ayat An-Nur, Allahu Nuru Samawati Wal Ard, there has been more commentary on this one verse, and more books and more treatises have been written about this one verse than all of the other verses in the Quran. It is the most oft commented verse in the whole Quran. And therefore, what can I do in 10-15 minutes that will explain to you the profundity of this verse? However, just to introduce to you, because it does relate to our theme of the reality of iman, the Ayat An-Nur, I will be taking a standard interpretation. Obviously, there are hundreds of interpretations. Of them are mainstream, of them are esoteric, of them are mystical and sufistic. I will be taking a mainstream interpretation. I will go over it very, very quickly. Allahu Nuru Samawati Wal Ard. Allah is the light of the heavens and earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the light of the heavens and earth, meaning number one, that He is the one who has created light, and light comes from Him. Number two, the light of guidance comes from Him. So the light here also refers to iman and hidayah, because throughout the Quran, light is used as a metaphor for guidance. So Allah calls the Quran light, wa anzalna ilaykum nuran mubina, and Allah calls the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam light, and He calls the message of Islam light. So when Allah says He is the Nur, so He is the source of that guidance. And then number three, Allahu Nuru Samawati Wal Ard, that we believe of the names of Allah is Nuru Samawati Wal Ard. And we understand that Allah Himself is Nur, and we do not think how. Our mind does not go to how, but Allah Himself is Nur. And we know this from the hadith in Sahih Muslim, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah's hijab is nur, hijabuhu nur. If Allah were to lift His hijab, then the nur that comes from the face of Allah, the rays of light that come from the face of Allah, would destroy all that Allah can see. So Allah Himself is nur. How? We don't think. Our mind does not go there. But Allah is Nur, and He Himself is Nur, and Allah's hijab is Nur. So Allah's hijab, which is Nur, is covering Allah's Nur. And if Allah's hijab were to be lifted, then the Nur of Allah would not be able to be withstood by any of the creation. And when Musa said to see Allah, Allah said, you cannot see me. You don't have the power to see me. And when Allah revealed a part of His Nur to the mountain, the mountain destroyed and collapsed. So Allah Himself is Nur, and Allah creates the nur that we know around us, and Allah is the one who is the guide as well. All of these three meanings are Allahu Nuru Samawati Wal Ard. Mathalu Nurihi, the example of His light. Ibn Abbas said, the example of His light is His light of iman that He blesses in the heart, in the qalb of the mu'min. So the whole metaphor that we will be taking in our quick lecture, and there are hundreds of other interpretations, but the most orthodox, the most Sunni, the most mainstream, from Ibn Abbas's mouth is the one I'm about to tell you. Overall, this was his interpretation, and that is, Ayat An-Nur is a metaphor for the iman in the heart of the believer. Ayat An-Nur is a metaphor for the iman in the qalb of the mu'min. So, مَثَلُ نُورِهِ, the example of Allah's light, which is His iman, which He places in the heart of the believer, is, now let's go on. كَمَثَلِ مِشْكَاتٍ فِيهَا مِصْبَاحٍ الْمِصْبَاحُ فِي زُجَاجَةٍ. Three things. Number one, the example of His light is like that of a mishkat. What is a mishkat? A mishkat is a crevice in a wall. A mishkat is an internal thing in a wall where the lantern is placed. Once upon a time, when they built the masajid, when they built a large house, they would have a crevice, a niche, and they would place the lanterns there. The purpose of the crevice or the niche is twofold. Number one, to protect the candle. Number two, to project the candle's light outward, to focus the light and make it all shine outward. So the first thing is the mishkat. And the mishkat, according to most commentators, it refers to the chest of the believer, the chest. مَثَلُونِكَ مِشْكَاتٍ فِيهَا مِصْبَاحٍ. Inside that mishkat is a misbah, that candle, the lantern. The lantern represents iman. Light is iman. Where is the lantern? الْمِصْبَاحُ فِي زُجَاجَ. It is inside a crystal, a glass. And the crystal and the glass is the qalb. So the qalb is inside the chest. Inside the qalb is what? The iman. Is that clear? Is that clear? Everybody need a simple interpretation, right? The mishkat is the chest. And the purpose of the chest is what? To project the iman outward. To manifest the iman in the body. To show, just like the niche projects the light outward. So that the niche takes the light and throws it back out. Everybody can see the light. So the purpose of the chest is to protect the heart and the iman. And then to manifest iman. To show iman in your actions, in your routine, in your hands, in your feet, in your tongue. So the chest will manifest, i.e. here the body. The body will manifest iman. And iman will be seen. The light of iman will be demonstrated through the actions of the body. That's the mishkat. Inside the mishkat is a misbah. The misbah is what? We said the iman that Allah places. The candle, the lantern. That is Allah's candle. That is Allah's light. That light is the light of iman. Where is that light housed? Fi zujaja. The zujaja. What is the zujaja? Zujaja means crystal. Zujaja means lantern. Zujaja means glass. And what is that crystal and that glass? The qalb of the mu'min. And what a beautiful metaphor. Because the qalb is like glass. Just like glass is fragile. Some glass is very fragile, very soft. So too some people's hearts are soft. Some glass, it is harder than steel. It's very harsh. So too some people's hearts are hard. Some glass is see-through. What they say, they believe. And other glass, it is dark and murky like that of a hypocrite. What they say is not what they believe. So Allah compares the qalb to the glass because glass is such a beautiful metaphor because glass has so many different variations. And the good glass, the pure glass is what? See-through. That's the best glass. So the heart of the believer, he's not a munafiq. He's not covering the light. The light is shining out. But the qalb of the munafiq, how will that be? That will not be clear. That will be murky. That will be dark. That will be different. The outside and the inside are two separate things. So Allah calls the qalb zujaja. And that is the glass. That is the lantern. That is the crystal. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam actually said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has vessels in this world. And the vessels of Allah are the qalb of his believers. The vessels he pours things into are the qalb of his believers. So in one hadith, our Prophet actually compared the qalb of the mu'min to the vessels of Allah. And in this ayah, we learn that the zujaja is in fact, according to one interpretation, the heart of the believer. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that the candle is inside of a zujaja, the heart. And so the heart inside of it is iman, and the heart is protected by the mishka, which is the body. And this light, this lantern, where does it get its oil from? يُوْقَدُ مِنْ شَجَرَةً. The every lantern, every candle, it has to have oil. Without it, it is not going to light. So where does this light of the candle, sorry, where does the oil of the candle come from? يُوْقَدُ مِنْ شَجَرَةٍ مُبَارَكَةً. Now this lecture will link in perfectly with two lectures ago. What is the shajara mubarakah? Who can tell me? The shajara of iman. We talked about that 2 days ago. Allah gives the metaphor of the shajara of iman, the tree of iman. In this ayah, Allah says the lantern's oil is coming from a blessed tree. And some of the sahaba said, this is the tree of iman. We talked about the tree of iman 2 lectures ago. Now we're using it again in another metaphor. That Allah says the oil that is used to light the heart and the candle, that oil is coming from the tree of iman. يُوْقَدُ مِنْ شَجَرَةٍ مُبَارَكَةٍ. And the best tree that oil comes from, زَيْتُونَ. It is an olive tree. لَا شَرْقِيَّةٍ وَلَا غَرْبِيَّةٍ. It's neither east nor west. It's not a tree of this world. It is a tree of the akhirah. It is the tree of Allah. It is the tree of iman. It's not a tree you're going to find. You can't go hunting for it in China, in Timbuktu. It's not sharqiyya or gharbiyya. It's neither east nor west. It is not of this world. It is the shajara of iman. It is beyond this world. And the zayt or the oil that comes from it. يُوْقَدُ مِنْ شَجَرَةٍ مُبَارَكَةٍ زَيْتُونَةٍ لَا شَرْقِيَّةٍ وَلَا غَرْبِيَّةٍ يَكَادُ زَيْتُهَا يُضِيءُ. The light, or sorry, the oil that comes from this tree is so pure. It is so bright. It is as if it is emanating light without any match touching it. Just the oil from the tree. يَكَادُ زَيْتُهَا يُضِيءُ وَلَوْ لَمْ تَمْسَسْهُ نَارُ. Even before any flame touches the oil itself is emanating light. So the tree of Iman is giving you an oil. That oil is being used to light your heart. The heart then has the Iman inside of the, the heart has the candle, which is Iman, inside of it. And then the body is manifesting that Iman. The body is then projecting that Iman and acting upon that Iman. Nurun ala nur, light upon light. The first light is the light of Allah, the light of the Quran. The second light is the light that is in the heart of the believer. So nurun ala nur, the Quran and the Iman of the believer, both of them come hand in hand together. We have Iman, the Quran has nur, and our Iman is nur, and the Quran is nur. Nurun ala nur, the Quran will give the nur to our Iman will get its nur from the Quran. Nurun ala nur. So both of these nurs are from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one of them is the Quran and the other is in our qalb. Nurun ala nur, both of these put together, light upon light. Yahdi Allahu linurihi man yasha. Allah guides to his light whomever he wills, because all light comes from Allah, because Allah is nurus samawati wal ard. So Allah is the one who gives us the oil, and he gives us the lamp, and he's the one who lights that lamp in our hearts, and he's the one who blesses our heart to be pure, and he protects our chest to project that Iman. So Allah is the one who gives that nur to whomever he pleases. يَهْدِ اللَّهُ لِنُورِهِ مَنْ يَشَاء. وَيَضْرِبُ اللَّهُ الْأَمْثَالَ لِلنَّاسِ. And Allah gives parables to mankind. وَاللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. For indeed Allah is aware of all things. This is a very short and a very basic commentary, and inshaAllah ta'ala it is also the most orthodox and mainstream commentary. This verse has also been misinterpreted. Very mystical and bizarre interpretations are also there, and I personally don't sympathize too much with those types of interpretations. This is the mainstream interpretation that you will find in Tafsir al-Tabari, Ibn Kathir, and the main scholars of Islam, and it is one that is a very sensible and a very comprehensible one. To summarize, Ayat An-Nur is a beautiful parable of the light of Iman in the heart of the believer, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the lantern, and he gives us the oil to light the lantern, and that lantern is in our qalb. The oil is from the Quran and the shajara of Iman. So nurun ala nur, both put together, is what makes a believer a believer. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us both of those nurs. We will inshallah ta'ala continue tomorrow. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.